δόξασι.
Είπεν ο Κύριος το Κυρίο μου κάθου εν δεξιόν μου.
Δεύτε ανυμνήσω με τη μητέρα του Σωτήρος, την μετατόκον πάλιν οφθήγησα. Παρθένο χαίρε πόλης έψυχε του βασιλέως και Θεού. Εν η Χριστός ηγή σας σωτηρίαν εργάσατο. Μετά του Γαβρίλ ανυμνούμεν σε, μετά των ποιμένων δοξάζομεν κράζοντες. Θεότο και πρέσβευε το εξουσία αρκωθέντη σωθήνε ημάς.
Εκαστρός προεσφόρου εγέννησας.
Ο πατήρι ρώκησεν, ο λόγος αρξεγένετο και η Παρθένος έτεκε Θεόν ανάνθρωπισαντα. Αστή ερμηνή, μάγοι προσκυνούσι, ημένες θαυμάζουσι και οι κτήσεις αγάλετε.
Ενείτε αυτόν εν την πάνω και χωρόν, ενείτε αυτόν εν χορδές και οργάνω.
Άγιος ειν ενεδίσου Στεφάνε μακάριε, πρωτομάρτης και πρωτοδιάκονε, των αγγέλων συμμετοχε, δυσοπίθητη και πρέσβευε υπέρ ημών προς τον Σωτήρα Κύριον των αναμάρτητων.
Yeah.
αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Υπερευλογημένη υπάρχεις Θεότο και Παρθένε, δια γάρτου εξού σαρκοθέντος, ο αντισυγμαλώτιστε, ο Αδάμ ανακαίκλητε, η κατάρανε νεκρότε, η Εύα ηλευθέρωτε, ο θάνατος τε θάνατοτε, και η μη σε ζωοποιηθήμε. Δύο ανυμνούν δεσμόμεν, ευλογητός Χριστός ο Θεός ημών, ο ούτος ευδοκίσαν δόξα σοι.
Δόξα σοι, τον δείξαντι το φως, δόξα εν υψίστης Θεός.
Θέλημά σου, ότι εσύ ο Θεός μου. στην πηγή ζωής, εν το φωτί σου ψώμεθα πως.
Προτείνον το ελαιός σου, της γήνος κουσίσε, Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός, Άγιος ισχυρός, Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Άγιο Πνεύματι,
σανήν και αΐ
και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον ημάς.
Άγιος ο Θεός,
Άγιος ισχυρός,
Άγιος αθάνατος ελέησον.
Σήμερον σωτηρίαν ο κόσμο γεγονέν, άσωμεν το αναστάντη εκ τάφου και αρχηγό τη ζωή ημών. Καθελών γαρ το θάνατο των θάνατων, τον οίκος εδωκέν ημίν και το μέγα ελέο.
Ευλογημένη βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Άγιου Πνεύματος νυν και άγιοι και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Εν ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεήθομεν.
For the peace from above, for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Υπέρ της ειρήνης του σύμπαντος κόσμου, ευσταθίας των Αγίων του Θεού Εκκλησιών και της των πάντων ενώσεως του Κυρίου δεήθομεν.
For this holy temple, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Αρχιεπίσκοπο και πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, του Τιμίου Πρεσβυτερίου της εν Χριστώ Διακονίας, παντός του κλήρου και του λαού, του Κυρίου δεήθομε.
Κύριε ελέησον.
For the President of the United States, for those in civil authority, for the armed forces, for all the American nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Υπέρ της κοινότητος και της πόλεως ταύτης, πάσης πόλεως και χώρας και των πίστικων των εν αυτές, του Κυρίου δεήθομεν.
For seasonable weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, For peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Υπερπλεόντων οδηπορούντων, αεροπορούντων, δοσούντων καμνόντων εκμαλώτων, και τη σωτηρία αυτών του Κυρίου δεήθωμεν.
For deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός, τη συγχαρητή. Της Παναγίας Σαχράντου υπερευλογημένης εν δόξου Δεσποινής ημών Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες, εαυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραθώμεθο.
For to thee belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Εξομολογήσω μέση, Κύριε, όλη καρδία μου, διηγήσω με πάντα.
O Lord our God, whose dominion is conceivable, whose glory is incomprehensible, whose mercy is infinite, whose love toward mankind is ineffable, do thou thyself, O Master, in thy tender compassion, look down upon us and upon those in this holy temple, and grant us and those who pray with us thy abundant mercy and compassion.
Και μεγαλοπρέπεια το έργον αυτού και η δικαιοσύνη αυτού μένει στον αιώνα του αιώνος.
By the praise of the Theotokos, Savior
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For yours is the dominion, the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Μακάριος ανή, ο φοβούμενος των Κύριων, εν τες εντολές αυτού θελήσεις φόδρα.
Master, Lord our God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Protect the whole body of thy church, sanctify those who love the beauty of their temple. To thou endow them with divine power, and forsake not us who set our hope in thee. Thou hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and did promise that when two or three are gathered together in your name, you will grant their petitions fulfilled. Now, Lord, the petitions of your servants as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and into the world to come life everlasting.
Amen.
δόξα και πλούτος εν το οίκο αυτού και η δικαιοσύνη αυτού μένει στον αιώνα του αιώνος. Δόξα Πατρί
και Υιώ και Άγιο Πνεύματι και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των
αιώνων.
Αμήν. Ο μόνο γεννησίος και λόγος του Θεού
αθάνατοι
παρών και κατά δεξαμένος ποιά την ηλετέρα σωτηρία σαρκωθείτε εκ της Αγίας Θεοτόκου και αι Παρθένου Μαρίας ατρέπτος εν απροπίσας σταυρωθείς και Χριστέ
και την ειρήνη του Κυρίου δεήθωμε.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Αντιλαβούς όσων ελέησον και διαφύλαξον ημάς ο Θεός της ηχαρίτη. Αγία Σακράντου, υπερευλογημένης εν δόξω δεσμίσιμον Θεοτόκου και αη Παρθένου Μαρίας, με τα πάντων των Αγίων μνημονεύσαντες σε αυτούς και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωήν ημών, Χριστού το Θεό παραθουμέθω. Ότι ο αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος Θεός υπάρχεις και εσύ την δόξα να αναπέμπομεν. Το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αυτή η μέρα Κυρίου αγαλιασόμεθα και φρανθόμεν εν αυτή των συνάναρχων λόγων και πνεύματι των εκπαρθένου τεχθέντα ισοτηρίαν ημών ανυμνήσομεν πιστή και προσκυνήσομεν ότι ευδόκη σε σαρκή ανεφήνεντο σταυρό και θάνατο υπομείνε γύρε τους τεθνεώτα εν τη εν δόξω Αναστάση αυτού.
Σοφία εν ορθή.
Δεύτε προσκυνήσομεν και προσπέσομεν Χριστό. Σώσον ημάς, Ιε Θεού, ο Αναστός εκ νεκρών.
Ψαλούντας η Αλληλούια.
Των συνάναρχων λόγων Πατρί και Πνεύματι, τον εκ Παρθένου τεκθέντα η σωτηρίαν ημών, ανυμνήσομεν πιστή και προσκυνήσομεν, ότι ευδόκησες αρκή, ανελθύν εν το σταυρό και θάνατον υπομείνεν. Και Κύριε τους τεθνεώτας, εν τη εν δόξω Αναστάσια,
Ευαγγελίζου Υιός ηφτώδα βίλ τα θαύματα το Θεό Πατορί, Παρθένον είδες κυοφορήσασαν, με τα μάγων προσεκίνησαν, με τα ποιμένων με δοξολόγησαν, διαγγέλου χρηματιστής, Οικέτευε Χριστόν τον Θεόν, σωθήνε τας ψυχάς ημών.
Βασίλειον διάδημα εστε φύση κορυφή, εξόφλων των υπέμεινας υπέρ Χριστού του Θεού, μαρτύρων πρωτόαθλε, σίγαρ την Ιουδαίαν απελέξας μανίαν, είδες σου το σωτήρα του Πατρός δεξιώθεν, αυτόν ουν εκδυσοποιάει υπέρ των ψυχών ημών.
Μνήστητη, Κύριε ως αγαθός των δούλων σου, και όσα εν βίω ημαρτών συγχωρείς, ουδείς γαράν αμάρτητος ημισιώ δύναμε, και της μεταστάσει δούμε την
Υπότιτλοι AUTHORWAVE.
Ascribe glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Holy God, rest among thy saints, and I'm glorified by the cherubim and the praise by the side of him with the thrice holy voice. Worship by all those in heaven, thou who hast brought all things out of nothingness into being, and thou hast created man in thy own image and likeness, who hast set into our memory all thy favors. For thou who gives to the supplicant wisdom and prudence, and give not neglect the sinner, but hast set forth the way of repentance unto salvation. Thou hast accounted us the humble and worthy servant worthy to stand at this time, for the glory of thy holy altar, and to bring thee the adoration and praise. Thou, Master, accepting the bond of the sinners, the thrice holy voice. Visit us in the righteousness, free us all transgression, voluntary and involuntary, sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship thee in holiness all the days of our life. Through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints who, from the beginning of time, have pleased thee, for thou art our God, our holy, and to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Εκείνες
Στέφανος, κύρις πίστεως και δυνάμεως, επί τέρατα και σημεία μεγάλα εν το λαό. Ανέστησε δε την έστ των επί συναγωγής της λεγωμένης Λιβερτίνων και Κυριναίων και Αλεξανδρέων και των από την Οικίας και Ασίας, συζητούντες το Στεφάνο και ούτ ίσιον αντιστήνε τη Σοφία και το πνεύμα του Ελλάδη. Τότε υπέβολαν άνδρας λέγοντας ότι εκυπώμεν αυτού λαλούντος ρήματα βάσφημα της Μωυσή και των Θεών. Συνεκίνησάντε των λαών και τους πρεσβυτέρους και τους γραμματείς και επιστάντες συνήπρασαν αυτών και ήραγον εις το συνέδριο έστησαν τε μάρτυρας ψευδής λέγοντας ο άνθρωπος ούτως σου πάβεται ρήματα βάσφημα λαλών κατά του τόπου του Αγίου και του νόμου. Ακυκόμεν γάρ αυτού λέγοντος ότι Ιησούς ο Ναζωραίος ούτως καταγήσει τον τόπο τούτο η αλλολάτσιτα έθνη απαρέδεκεν ημίν Μωυσής. Και ατενήσεν εσείς αυτοράπαντες οι καθεζόμενοι εν το συνεδρίο είδον το πρόσωπον αυτού ως η πρόσωπον αντέλου. Είπε δε ο αρχιερεύς, ή άρα ταύτα ούτως έχει, ο δε έφη, άνδρες, αδελφοί και πατέρες, ακούσατε, ο Θεός της δόξης όφθη το πατρί ημών Αβραάμ, όντι εν τη Μεσοποταμία, πριν κατοικήσε αυτόν εν χαράν, και είπε προς αυτόν, έξαφε της γης σου και της συγγενείας σου, και δεύρω εις γήν εν αν συνδείξω. Τότε εξαλθών ευχής Χαλδαίων, κατόκισεν εν χαράν, κακήθεν μετά το αποθανήν τον πατέρα αυτού, μετόκισεν αυτόν εις την γην ταύτη, εις ειν ημείς νυν κατοικείται. Και ουκ έδωκεν αυτό κληρονομία εν αυτή, ουδέ βήμα ποδός. Σολομών δε οκοδόμησε αυτό ήχον. Αλούχο ύψιστος εν κυροποιήτης ναής κατοικεί, καθώς ο προφήτης λέγει, ο θρόνος μη ο ουρανός μη θρόνος, η δε γη υποπόδιον των ποδών μου. Ποιον οίκον οικοδομήσε τέμι, λέγει Κύριος, ή τις τόπος της καταπαύσεώς μου. Ουχή η χείρ μου επίησε τα αυτά πάντα. Σφυροτράχυνη και απερίτμητη τη καρδία και τη σωσήν, η μίσα ή το πνεύμα του Αγίο αντιπίπτεται ως οι πατέρες ημών και εμείς. Κίνα των προφητών ουκ εδίωξαν οι πατέρες ημών και απέχνιναν τους προκαταγγείλοντας περί της ελεύσεως του δικαίου ουν γίνει εμείς προδότε και φωνήζει γέννηστε. Ήτινε σε λάβετε των νόμων εις διαταγάς αγγέλων και ουκ εφυλάξατε. Ακούοντας δε ταύτα, διεπρίοντο τες καρδίες αυτών και έβριχον τους οδόντας επ' αυτών. Υπάρχον δε πλήρης πνεύματος Αγίου, ατενήσας εις την ουρανόν, είδε δόξαν Θεού, και ισούν εστώτα εκ δεξιών του Θεού και είπεν, «Ιδού θεωρώ τους ουρανούς ανεωγμένους και τον Υιόν του ανθρώπου εκ δεξιών του Θεού εστώτα». Κράξαντες δε φωνή μεγάλη, συνέσχον τα ότα αυτών και όρμησαν ομοθυμαδών επ' αυτών και εκβαλώντες έξω της πόλεως ελιθοβόλουν. Και οι μάρτυρες απέθεντο τα ημάτια αυτών παρά τους πόδας νεανίου καλωμένου σάβλου και ελιθοβόλουν τον Στέφανον επικαλούμενον και λέγοντα «Κύριε Ιησού, δέξε το πνεύμα μου». Θείς δε τα γόνατα έκραξε φωνή μεγάλη. Κύριε, μη στήσεις αυτή στην αμαρτία ταύτη. Και τούτο υπόν ετοιμήσει.
Let us be attentive.
Their voice has gone out into all the earth. The heavens declare the glory of God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the Acts of the Apostles.
Let us be attentive.
In those days, Stephen, full of grace and power, did great wonders and signs among the people. Then some of those who belonged to the synagogue of the freedmen, as it was called, and of the Cyrenians, and of the Alexandrians, and of those from Sicilia and Asia, arose and disputed with Stephen. But they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke. Then they secretly instigated men who said, "We have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and God." And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes. And they came upon him and seized him and brought him before the council and set up false witnesses who said, "This man never ceases to speak words against this holy place and the law. For we have heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth will destroy this place and will change the customs which Moses delivered to us." And gazing at him, all who sat in the council saw that his face was like the face of an angel. And the high priest said, "Is this so?" And Stephen said, "Brethren and fathers, hear me. The God of glory appeared to our father Abraham when he was in Mesopotamia, before he lived in Haran, and said to him, 'Depart from your land and from your kindred, and go into the land which I will show you.' Then he departed from the land of the Chaldeans and lived in Haran. And after his father died, God removed him from there into this land in which you are now living. Yet he gave him no inheritance in it, not even a foot's length, but promised to give it to him in possession and to his posterity after him, though he had no child. But it was Solomon who built a house for him. Yet the Most High does not dwell in houses made with hands. As the prophet says, 'Heaven is my throne and earth my footstool.' What house will you build for me, says the Lord, or what is the place of my rest? Do not my hand make all these things? You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit. As your fathers did, so do you. Which of the prophets did not your fathers persecute? And they killed those who announced beforehand the coming of the Righteous One, whom you have now betrayed and murdered, who you received the law as delivered by angels and did not keep it." Now when they heard these things, they were enraged, and they ground their teeth against him. But he, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And he said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out with a loud voice and stopped their ears and rushed together upon him. Then they cast him out of the city and stoned him. And the witnesses laid down their garments at the feet of a young man named Saul. And as they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." And he knelt down and cried with a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And we had said this, he fell asleep.
Be with you, the readers.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Sophia, orthi akousomen tou Agiou Evangelion.
Ειρήνη πόση.
And with your spirit.
Εκ του καταμαρθέων Αγίου Ευαγγελίου το ανάγνωσμα προσκομέν.
Glory to
αναχωρισάντων των μάγων, ιδού άγγελος Κυρίου φαίνεται κατών αρτωρ Ιωσήφ λέγον, εγερθείς παράλαβε το παιδίον και την μητέρα αυτού και φεύγε εις Αίγυπτον και ίσθη εκεί έως ανήπωση. Μέλιγαρ Ηρώδης ζητήν το παιδίον του απολέσε αυτό, Ο δε εγκερθείς παρέλαβε το παιδίον και τη μητέρα αυτού νυκτός και ανεχώρησεν εις Αίγυπτον και είναι εκεί έως της τελευτής Ηρώδου ή να πληρωθεί το ρηθέν υπό του Κυρίου διά του προφήτου λέγοντος «Εξ Αιγύπτου εκάλεσα τον υιόν μου». Τότε Ηρώδης ειδών ότι ενεπέχθη από τον μάγον εθυμώθη Λίαν και αποστήλας ανήλε πάντα στους πέδας τους εν Βηθλεέμ και εν πάση της ορίς αυτής από διετούς και κατωτέρω κατά των χρόνων ον εκρύβωσε παρά των μάγων. Τότε επληρώθη το ρηθέν υπό Ιερεμίου το προφήτου λέγοντος «Φωνή εν Ραμά οικούστη, θρήνος και χλαθμός και οδυρμός πολλής, Ραχήλ κλαίουσα τα τέκνα αυτής και ουκ ήθελε παρακληθήνε ότι ουκ εισή». Τελευτίσαντος δε του Ηρώδου ιδού άγγελος Κυρίου κατόναρ, φαίνεται το Ιωσήφ εν Αιγύπτο, λέγον «Εγερθείς παρέλαβε το παιδίον και την μητέρα αυτού και πορεύου εις γάρ Ισραήλ». Τεθνίκασι γάρ, ειζητούντες την ψυχήν του παιδίου, ο δε εγερθείς παρέλαβε το παιδίον και την μητέρα αυτού και ήρθεν εις γήν Ισραήλ. Ακούσας δε ότι αρχέλεος βασιλεύει επί της Ιουδαίας αντί Ηρώδου του πατρός αυτού, εφοβήθη εκεί απερθήν. Γραμματιστής δε κατόναρ ανεχώρησεν εις τα μέρη της Γαλιλαίας και ελθόν κατόκισεν εις πόλην λεγόμενον Ναζαρέτ. Όπως πληρωθεί το ρηθέν διά των προφητών, ότι Ναζαρέος κληθήσετε.
The reading is taken from the Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Let us be attentive. When the wise men departed, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Rise, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt, and remain there till I tell you, for Herod is about to search for the child in order to destroy him." And so he rose and took the child and his mother by night and departed to Egypt and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet, "Out of Egypt have I called my son." Then Herod, when he saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, was in a furious rage, and he sent and killed all the male children in Bethlehem and in all that region, who were 2 years old or under, according to the time which he had ascertained from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they were no more. But when Herod died, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, saying, "Rise, take now the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who sought the child's life are dead." And he rose and took the child and his mother and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus reigned over Judea in the place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And being warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and there he went and dwelt in a city called Nazareth. In order that might be fulfilled what was spoken by the prophets, might be fulfilled, he shall be called a Nazarene.
By your power, we may give glory to you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
No one who is bound with the desires and pleasures of the flesh is worthy to approach or draw near or to serve thee, O King of glory, for to serve thee is great and awesome even to the heavenly powers. Yet through thine ineffable and boundless love toward mankind, thou didst unchangeably and immutably become man and served as our high priest, and as Lord of all is committed to us the celebration of liturgical and bloodless sacrifice. For thou alone, our Lord, our God, who is over all things in heaven and earth, who art born on the throne of the cherubim, and our Lord of the seraphim and King of Israel, who alone art holy and rested among thy saints, wherefore implore thee, who alone art good and ready to listen, look down upon me, thy sinful and unprofitable servant, and cleanse my soul and my heart from an evil conscience, and enable me by the power of the Holy Spirit, and bless me with the grace of the priesthood, to stand before this thy holy altar and consecrate thy holy and immaculate body and precious blood. To thee I come, having bowed my head and beseech thee, turn not thy face away from me, neither reject from among thy children, but make me worthy of thy sinful and unworthy servant to offer these gifts unto thee, for thou art the offer, the accepted tribute of Christ our God, and to thee ascribe glory together, eternal Father, and thy life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Ita hierovimis cosa good news and desket is of your triadi to the Sion, even on prosado, as passant via the Kirpathori Merimnon. Ήτα χειροβήμ εις τυχώς εκνίζοντες και τους οποίο τριάδιν το τρισάγιον ύμνον προσάδοντες πάσαν τη βιώ την παθόρη μέρημνα. Ήτα χειροβήμ εις τυχώς εκνίζοντες και τους οποίο τριάδιν το τρισάγιον ύμνον προσάδοντες πάσαν τη βιώ την παθόρη μέρημνα.
us in this kingdom, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Σωμέν την δέησιν ημών το Κύριον.
For these precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Κύριε ελέησον.
Αντιλαβούς όσον ελέησον και διαφυλάξον ημάς ο Θεός τη συγχαρητή.
For this whole day, that it may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Άγγελον ειρήνης πιστών οδηγών, φύλακα των ψυχών και των σωμάτων ημών, παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
For the forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Τα καλά και συμφέροντα τες ψυχές ημών και ειρήνη το κόσμο, παρά του Κυρίου ετήσωμεθα.
That we may complete the remainder of our lives in peace and penitence, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Χριστιανά τα τέλη της ζωής ημών, ανώδυναν επέσχυντα ειρηνικά και καλήν απολογίαν, την επί του φοβερού βήματος του Χριστού ετήσωμεθαν.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, most blessed, and glorified Lady Theotokos, and ever-Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
Δια των εκτερμών του μονογενού σου Υιουμεθού ευλογήτωση, συν το Παναγίο και αγαθό και ζωπιό σου πνεύματι, νυν και αείμ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the true
nos in matrimonio.
Τα στήρας εν σοφία προσκομέν.
Πιστεύω εις ένα Θεόν, Πατέρα Παντοκράτορα,
ποιητήν ουρανού και γης ρωτώνται πάντων και ευράτων, και εις ένα Κύριον Ιησούν Χριστόν, τον Υιόν του Θεού τον Μονογενή, τον εκ Πατρός ενηθέντα προπάντων των αιώνων, φως εκ φωτός,
Θεόν αληθινών εκ Θεού
αληθινού, γεννηθέντα ο πιθέντα, ομοούσιον το πατρίδιο τα πάντα γένετο.
Μας ανθρώπους και δια τη μετέραν σωτηρίαν καταφθόνται εκ των ουρανών
και σακωθέν και πνεύματος Αγίου και Μαρίας της Παρθένου και να ανθρωπίσεντα. Σταυρωθέντεται υπέρ ημών υπείου Πιλάτου και παθώνται και τα φέντα και αναστάνται η τρίτη ημέρα καρσκαφάς.
Και ανελθόντα εις τους ουρανούς
ζώμουν εκ δεξιών του Πατρός και πάλι ερχόμενο με τα δόξης.
Κρίνεζόντας και νεκρούς, ούτης βασιλείου
στο τέλος. Και εις το πνεύμα του Άγιον, των Κύριων, των Ζωπιών, των εκ Πατρός προβόμενων, των συμπατρί και Υιός συμπροσκυνούμενων και συμπροσεζόμενων των λαλήσαν διά των προφητών.
Εις μίαν Αγία, καθολικήν και αποστολικήν εκκλησία,
ομολογώ εν βάπτισμα εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών,
προσδοκώ νεκρών και ζωή του μέλλοντος αιώνος.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men, for our salvation, came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Στο μεν καλό, στο μεν με το φόβο, προσκομέν την Αγία Αναφορών, εν ειρήνη προσφέρει. And the love of God the Father, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
His blessed power is a master who loves mankind. We also pray and say, Holy Earth, thou and all holy. And only begotten Son, and the Holy Spirit, Holy Earth, thou and all holy. May the Christ is thy glory who gets on the world. Taken bread in his holy and immaculate and blameless hands, and having thanked, blessed, and sanctified him, and the disciples and apostles, saying, το σώμα του επέρημαν κολλόμενον εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Take ye, this is my body, which for you is broken unto remission of sins. Likewise the cup after the supper, saying, Ποιο δεξ' αυτού πάντες, τούτο εστί το αίμα μου το της καινής διαθήκης, το επέρημον και πολλών ευκοινόμενον εις άφεσιν αμαρτιών. Drink from it, ye all. This is my blood of the New Testament, which for you and for many is shed unto remission of sins. So ecton son si prosferomen kada panda ke dia panda. Supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here presented. Make this bread the precious body of thy Christ, and that which is in this cup the precious blood of thy Christ, changing them by the descent of the Holy Spirit. Mothers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith.
Thank you. Πρώτη εις μίστη την Κύριε του Αρχιεπισκόπου και Πατρός ημών Ιακώβου, ον χάρισε της Αγίας σου Εκκλησίας εν ειρήνη, σον εν ημών Ιάμαρχου μερεύοντα, και ορθοτομούντο των λόγων της εις αληθείας.
Κι ον έκαστος κατά διάνοιαν έχει και πάντων και πασόν. And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honored and majestic name, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
In the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, shall be with you all.
Having remembered all the saints, let us again in peace pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord. That our loving God, who has received them at his holy, heavenly, and spiritual altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Having prayed for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. Και καταξίωσον ημάς δέσποτα μετά παρησίας, ακατακρίτως τον μαν επικαλείστεσε, τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγειν.
Πάτερ ημών, ο εν της ουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης, τον άρτον ημών των επιούσιων, δώσι μην σήμερον, και άφηση μην τα αφηλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφήμεν σε φιλέτης ημών, και εμείς εν έγκυση μας φιλοσμών, αλλά ρίσα ημάς από το πονηρού. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Ειρήνη πόση.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of all ages.
The holy gifts unto the holy.
One is holy, one is Lord.
Κύριε και η δημιουργία τη έμπνευση του δημιουργού, ο μοίρο, ο πάντα τη τιόμενο και με δέπα το δωμάτιο. Συγγνώμη, σε γιάζω. Ζέστης πίστης πλήρης πνεύματος Αγίου.
Son of God, as partake of their mystical feast, we not speak of the mystery to his enemies, who not just his Judas, but as the blood of the promise of their kingdom. Tremble, beholding thine blood. For there's a lighted coal burning the unworthy in God's body, and thine by the righteous and verse our Son. Thou hast smitten us with the burning of Christ, and with the divine love, who has changed us. But do the way with burning us, and show us our sins. In the magnificence of the saints, how shall we, the unworthy, enter? For should we also dare to enter the blessed chamber, our robe chooses? For it is not a vessel of armor, and we shall be bound and cast out by the angels. Cleanse our souls, and O Lord, and upon their flesh, and save us. O merciful Master, Lord Jesus Christ, the God, let not these holy gifts be unto us for judgment, through unworthiness, but rather for the purification and sanctification of our souls and bodies. And as a nurse, I'd like the kingdom to come. For it is good, and yes, please, O Lord, and the house of salvation. Του δείπνου ή του μυστικού σύμπρινου δίνου κοινού παράλαβε, ο μη γάντη εκθρήσου των μυστηρίων, είπε ο φίλη μα εδώ κατά πεούδα, αλλά όσο μυστήριο ο μυστήριο σου. Θεό ελάστη μη τα μαρτυρούν, Θεό ελάστη μη τα μαρτυρούν, Θεό ελάστη μη τα μαρτυρούν, Θεό Έτι μεταδίδεται με Τιμωθέο τον Αξίου, Ιερομονάχου, το Τίμη και Παράγιον. Σώμα εις αξιμαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Έτι μεταδίδεται με Τιμωθέο τον Αξίου, Ιερομονάχου, το Τίμη και Παράγιον. Αίμα εις αξιμαρτιών και ζωήν αιώνιον. Αμήν. Αμήν, τούτο ύψο με λέω που περί μου καθαρή.
Thank you.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art verily the Christ, the Son of the living God, who didst come into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Also, I believe that this is thy sacred body and this thy precious blood. Therefore, I pray to thee, have mercy on me and pardon my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, both known and unknown. And make me worthy to partake of thy sacred mysteries, unto the remission of sins and unto life eternal. Amen. Behold, I approach for Holy Communion. O Creator, burn me not as I partake, for thou art fire which burns the unworthy. Wherefore do thou cleanse me from every stain. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of thy mystical feast, for I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies. I will not kiss thee as did Judas, but as the thief I will confess thee. Lord, remember me when thou comest in thy kingdom. Tremble, O mortal, beholding the divine blood, for it is as a lighted coal burning the unworthy. It is God's body and deifieth and nourisheth me. It deifieth my soul and wondrously nourisheth my mind. Thou hast smitten me with yearning, O Christ, and with a divine love thou hast changed me. But do thou burn away with spiritual fire my sins, and make me worthy to be filled with the joy of thee, that rejoicing in thy goodness, I may magnify thy two presences. Into the magnificence of thy saints, how shall I, the unworthy, enter? For should I also dare to enter the festal chamber, my robe betrays me, for it is not a festal garment, and I shall be bound and cast out by the angels. Cleanse my soul, O Lord, from pollution, and by thy compassion save me. O merciful Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be unto me for judgment through my unworthiness, but rather for the purification and sanctification of my soul and body, and as an earnest of the life and kingdom to come. For it is good for me to cleave unto God and to place in the Lord hope of my salvation. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of thy mystical feast. For I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies. I will not kiss thee as did Judas, but as the thief I confess thee. Lord, remember me when thou comest in thy kingdom.
Μετά φόβο Θεού πίστεως και αγάπης προσέλθετε, with the fear of God, faith and love approach.
Πιστεύω, Κύριε, και ομολογώ ότι εσύ αληθώς ο Χριστός, ο Υιός του Θεού του Ζώντος, ο ελθόνης του κόσμου αμαρτωλούς σώσε, ον πρώτος είμαι εγώ. Έτι πιστεύω ότι τούτο αυτό εστί το άχρονον σώμα σου και τούτο αυτό εστί το τίμιον αίμα σου, δέω με ουν σου. Ελέησόμε και συγχωρήσόμε τα παρακτώματά μου, τα εκούσια και τα ακούσια, Thy logo, thy nerve, thy
voice, thy everlasting.
Thy axios some echatakritos metasini, thy ramus mysterion, thy sophos in the martion, thy zoon, amin. Thy duva diso prostian kinonia, and plastodia mit flexus metimetusia. Pirgari pachis tus axios flagon, aun catheron, ec passis metididos. Του δείπνου σου του μυστικού, σήμερον η Θεού, κοινωνών με παράδε. Τη μήγα της εκκλήσου το μυστήριον είπο, του φίλη μας ειδός ο καθάπερο Ιούδας, αλλός ο ληστής ομολογώσει, νίστη την Κύριε εν τη βασιλεία σου. Θεωργών αίμα φρίξων άνθρωπο βλέπων, άνθρωπος χαριστή τους αναξίους φλέγων, Θεού το σώμα και Θεοί με τη πέφη, Θεοί το πνεύμα που δεν νουν τρέπει ξένος. Έθωξα σπόθωνα Χριστέ και ηγείουσα στο Θείο σου έργος. Αλλά κατάφλεξον πήρια ήλω της αμαρτίας μου και αντιστήθης εσύ φύγης καταξίωσον. Είναι τας δύο σχετών μεγαλήνου αγαθέ παρουσία σου.
Servant of God.
Εν δες λαμπρότης ευαγγείων σου, πώς της ελεύσουν με ο ανάξιος. Εάν γάρκο μίσος εις οθήνης των υφώνα, ο χιτών με ελέγχει, ότι ου κρέστη του γάμου και δέσμιος εκδολούν υπό τον διάλον. Καθάρισον, Κύριε, τον ρήπον της ψυχής μου και σώσον με ως φιλάνθρωπος. Δέσον τα φιλάνθρωπε, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ, ο Θεός μου, μης κρίμα μη γέννη το τα Άγια Τάφρα και των ανάξιων είναι με. Αλλά εις κάτρασιν και αγιασμόν ψυχής και σώματος και εις αραβόνα μελούς της ζωής και βασιλείας. Εμ ιδέα του προσκολάσου του Θεού, αγαθόνεστη, τίθεστε με Κυρίο την ελπίδα της σωτηρίας μου. Του δείπνου σου του μυστικού, σήμερον η Θεού, κοινωνώ με παράλαβε, που μη γάτης εχθήσου το μυστήριον είπο, που φίλοι μας ηλώσω καθάπρο Ιούδας, αλλός ο ληστής ομολογώσει, νίστητη μου Κύριε εν τη βασιλεία σου, νίστητη μου Δέσποτα εν τη βασιλεία σου, νίστητη μου Άγιε εν τη βασιλεία σου.
Servant of God, servant of God, servant of God, servant of God, servant of God,
servant of God. 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 Servant of life everlasting. Servant of God.
Servant of God.
Remission of our sins and for life everlasting. Servant of God. Servant of God.
Servant of God.
Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Servant of God. Everlasting. Amen. Servant of God.
Σώσον ο Θεός των λαών σου και ευλόγησον την κληρονομία σου.
Είδομεν το φως το αληθινόν, ελάβομεν πνεύμα επουράνιον, εύρωμεν πίστην αληθή, αδιαιρετών τριάδα προσκυνούντες. Αυτή η χάρη μας εσώσε.
Πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Let us rise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ. Worthily let us give thanks unto the Lord.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Οδησίου αιάσμος ημών γέση την δόξαν εν απέμπωμεν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύματος νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας. Το νεονό. Let us depart in peace.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Kyrie eleison,
bless those who praise you and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power, and do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to the armed forces, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. To you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Christ our God, you are the fulfillment of the law and the prophets. You have fulfilled all the dispensation of the Father, till our hearts which are your own souls now and forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. The company of saints has found the source of life and the entrance to paradise. May I find to the way through repentance, for I am the lost and stray sheep. Bring me back to you, O Savior, and save me.
Ευλογητώσει, Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματά σου. Ανάπαυσον ο Θεός τους δούλους σου και κατάταξον αυτούς εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εκλάμψους είναι ως φωσίδες. Και κοιμημένους δούλους σου ανάπαυσον παρορών αυτών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The true brilliance of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, co-beginningless Son, and Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Thank you. κατά πάσης Κύριε, όπου Πάτες οι Αγίοι Σου αναπαύονται. Αναμώσον Κύριε, και δασκάλισον δούλων Σου, ότι μόνος υπάρχεις αθάνατος.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. You are God, who descended into Hades, and ended the suffering of all who were in prison. O Savior, also rest the souls of these your servants.
We pray to you, hear us and have mercy. Again, we pray for the repose of the souls of the servants of God, Alcestis, Vasiliki, Peter, Lycurgos, and John, who have fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all their errors, both voluntary and involuntary. That the Lord God will place their souls where the righteous rest, and will grant to them the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and God. Let us pray to the Lord.
O God of spirit and of all flesh, who has trampled down death, crushed the power of the devil, and granted life to your world, do you yourself, O Lord, give rest to the souls of these your servants, Alcestis, Vasiliki, Peter, Lycurgos, John, who have fallen asleep in a place of light, a place of green pasture, a place of repose, where there is no grief, sorrow, or mourning. Forgive every sin which they have committed in word or deed or thought. For you are a good God who loves mankind, for there is no one who lives and does not sin. Only you are without sin. Your righteousness is everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Της η Αναστασή στη ζωή και μακαρία ανάπαυση των κεκειμένων δούλων σου, Αλκής της Βασιλικής Παναγιώτου Λυκούργου και Ιωάννου, Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών και εσύ την δόξαν αναπέμπωμεν, σύ το Ανάξου Πατρί και το Παναγίο και αγαθό και στο ποιό σου πνεύμα την ίν και αΐ, και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Αιωνία σύμνη μιάξου μακάριστη και μνηστή αδελφοί ημών.
May your memories be eternal, our blessed and ever memorable brothers and sisters. Eunia
simni mi aksomakaristi kemnisti adelfi imon. Κύριο και Λεός αυτού εθυμάστη αυτού Θεία χάρη τη και φιλανθρωπία πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Δόξα σε ο Θεός, ελπίσιμον, Κύριε, δόξα σε.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε λαίσον, Κύριε λαίσον, Κύριε λαίσον, Πάτερ Άγιε ευλόγησον.
Ο εν σπηλαίω γεννηθείς και εν φάγει ανακληθείς δια την ημών σωτηρίαν. Ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών Χριστός ο νεθρός Θεός ημών. Τες πρεσβείας της Παναχράντου και προμόμα Αγίας αυτού Μητρός. Δυνάμει του Τιμίου και Εζωπίου Σταυρού, προστασία του Τιμίου Επράνιων Δυνάμεων Σωμάτων, ηγεσία του Τιμίου Ενδόξου Προφήτου, Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, του Εναγίου Πατέρων Ιμών και Μεγάλων Ιωκών Κοιμικών Δασκάλων, του Εναγίου Πατρός Ιμών Ιωάννου, Αρχιεπισκόπου Κωνσταντινούπολη Χριστόμου, των Αγίων Ενδόξων και Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, των Οσίγων Θεοφόρων Πατέρων Ιμών, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατρών Ιωακήμ και Άνιες, των Αγίων Στεφάνου του Πρωτομάρτυρος, Θεοδόρου Οσίου του Γραπτού και πάντων των Αγίων ελέης και σώσε εμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και ελέημον Θεός. Διευχούν των Αγίων Πατέρων ημών, Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ ο Θεός, ελέησον και σώσον ημάς.
The Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ is born. Glorify Him. I pray that each and every one of you had a spiritually uplifting celebration of the feast day of Christmas. Now that all the gifts have been opened and most of the food and the sweets have been eaten, our church, in a way, snaps our attention back into place with the gospel reading which we heard during the Divine Liturgy. This gospel reading picks up the Christmas story just after the Magi have left to return to Babylon. It's come time for Joseph and Mary to return home as well. But the warm and happy feelings of the Christmas story come to an abrupt and crashing halt. Herod the king realizes that the Magi have betrayed him, and he orders that all the children in Bethlehem and the surrounding areas aged 2 years and under, to be killed in an attempt to kill the Christ among them. These children who died for Christ's sake are known in our church's tradition as the Holy Innocents. They are the victims of the first attack against Christ and his church. The persecutions from that day forth have never really ended. But if we look at our modern day society, especially here in America, we'll see, and I'll get into this a little bit later, that the type of persecution that we face is much different than those of the past. And our challenge as Christians living in today's world is to continue to grow, and to continue to grow spiritually and closer to Christ in the face of this new and deadly persecution. As I noted earlier, Christ and his church have been persecuted, have been under attack since day one. These attacks, however, have never stopped the church from growing, nor has it stopped the gospel from spreading. Tradition holds that over 14,000 children were killed by Herod after Christ's birth. Even so, Christ survived and fulfilled the mission he was born to do. The saint that we celebrate today in our church, Saint Stephen, the first martyr and the archdeacon, was killed shortly after Christ's resurrection for preaching the gospel to the Jews. Even so, in the book of Acts, we hear that the church grew rapidly in those days, from 12 to 70 to 120 to 3,000 and 5,000 and so forth and so forth. These persecutions continued, especially for 3 centuries in the Roman Empire. But out of these persecutions, the Christian church survived and became even the religion of the Roman Emperor when Saint Constantine the Great converted to Christ. Even so, the attacks on Christ's church never ended, continuing in the Ottoman Empire, the Soviet Russian provinces, where millions of Orthodox Christians were killed for believing in Christ. And even in today's world in the Middle East, with ISIS and other extremist Muslim groups killing and slaughtering Christians as if they were sheep or lambs for who they believe in. Even so, the church has survived and is actually very strong and is growing in many places of the world and continues to preach the good news of Jesus Christ. We, however, do not live in that reality. We don't live under that type of persecution. Today we've come to church, we've come to the divine liturgy with no threat of punishment nor of violence. Yet we as Christians are still facing many, many attacks on our faith. What do I mean by this? If we're not being attacked as in the former persecutions, how are we being attacked? Well, we live in a society that teaches us, that teaches our children in their schools, that the people and the events of the Bible and the core teachings of our faith are not real. That it's impossible for a virgin to become pregnant and bear a child. That it's impossible for a man who has been crucified and died and buried to return from the dead. We live in a society that values material wealth, comfort, sports and entertainment above a relationship with God. We live in a society that encourages us to do whatever it is that makes us feel good, even if that something is destructive to ourselves and to others. We live in a society which makes us our own God. We write our own rules. We do whatever we want. We get what we want when we want it. Apathy and self-contentedness and egoism are even more dangerous to the Christian church than swords or bullets. Because while steel and guns kill the body, these other persecutions that we face today kill our soul. All of us have our passions. We all have our distractions that pull us away from Christ. None of us are exempt, myself included. And if we think about the willing sacrifice of Saint Stephen or the Holy Innocents, or the thousands upon thousands of martyrs that have given everything for their faith in God, I believe we would truly feel humbled. This is our persecution, the attack that is trying to kill Christ in the world, And we face it many times without realizing it every single day. So how do we meet this persecution head on, as did the saints of our church throughout the centuries? In other words, how do we become martyrs in our own lives? And if we look at the word martyr and what it actually means, where it comes from, it really has nothing to do with being killed per se. The word martyr, martyros in Greek, means to be a witness, to testify that something is true. For our saints, they gave their testimony by offering their lives. We can do so, however, by making a dedicated effort every single day to eliminating those passions, those distractions from our lives, so that we can be the best Christians we can be and shine for the entire world to see us. It's very easy to say this, but how is it done? Well, we do this through spiritual disciplines, such as prayer, as fasting, charity and almsgiving, reading and knowledge of the scriptures, and the lives of the saints, through confession and repentance, and of course, coming to church as we have all done today to participate in the divine liturgy and the sacraments of the church. Just as the martyrs sacrificed their own lives for Christ, we too must sacrifice not our lives, but our own free will, so that the will of God can direct us, Himself. Of course, we will never be perfect. We will always fall, because only Christ is perfect. But the more we do these things, the more we integrate these spiritual disciplines into our lives, the more we give from our own desires to fulfill God's desires for us, we open ourselves and our hearts to God's love, and we start making Christianity, our faith in Christ, part of our identity. And when that happens, when we feel like being a Christian is part of who we are, then the church and our life in the church moves from something that we do, an activity that we participate in, to being who we are, to being us. I am Dimitri, I am a Christian. Just as St. Paul says in the scriptures, it is not I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Let us then follow our role models, St. Stephen, the holy innocents, and all the martyrs, to give everything we have to follow Christ in our lives. They are the proof, they are the witness that these persecutions we face are temporary, while the reward that we receive is eternal and wonderful beyond understanding. Let us try our best to avoid the modern-day persecutions and pitfalls, and instead be witnesses to the true faith of Christ with our words and with our actions and with our spirit. Let us completely direct our life to God and to Christ, that He may guide us safely into His heavenly kingdom. Amen. Very quickly, I want to thank our junior choir, who sang beautifully for us today during the Divine Liturgy, and we thank them. And I wanted to remind everybody that on New Year's Day, January 1st, we'll be having Orthros at 8:30 and Divine Liturgy at 9:30 for the feast day of St. Basil the Great. So please join us on that day. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Chronia pola. επιτελέσεις.